One of those on hand at the Livingston Parish Chamber, where Layden Ricks, the parish president, was the keynote speaker with Sheriff Jason Ard. And it occurs to me that a lot of the issues he talked about, the fact that this parish had the flood in 16 that was beyond description as a natural disaster, then Hurricane Ida, a direct hit by a Category 4 hurricane, the eye came over Livingston Parish. I mean, these were monumental events that have taxed him. But your office, too, I remember seeing on Facebook the night of the storm that you were out in the storm. Yes. And then look at the damage to everything.
It's just a disaster. I mean, look, I've been around for 29 years at the sheriff's office. I've worked a lot of storms. A lot of people will never forget, you know, when Katrina came through and then Andrew before that. And, you know, we had Gustav and we had Isaac. I mean, just so many storms. This storm, when it came through, I remember being at home for the first time, and that was just our plan. We had a strategy plan to actually work from home because we knew there'd be a lot of trees down and trying to work ourselves out. But I remember telling myself that we should have not been home with our families. You heard sounds I have never heard before. It was the worst hurricane that I have ever been through, and it has. I mean, we've been through a lot. We had the flood in 16, devastated over 85 to 90% of our parish. This storm was just so many trees down, and it really impacted the whole parish, but mostly your southeast part of the parish was very, very well impacted, along with Tangipahoa.
But you have to believe, I mean, your department's been through this, and now the labor shortage.
Yes.
I mean, where would you say you stand? Your deputies must have been traumatized as much as anybody.
The deputies were traumatized, but I'm very lucky. What we have learned in the past, that one of the things that we do whenever we have these storms coming, we prepare and get ready. And one of the things that I do is I always tell people this: I have 24 hours to get my deputies whole. We had contractors we'd already negotiated with to make sure we put the deputies first in line. And the reason we do that is if you need me, and that after that 24 hours, I don't have a deputy to send you, I can't help you. So I got to get my deputies whole. And they do go through a lot. And look, I like to say this, because if you back up during Katrina, we learned for the first time that we're just not law enforcement officers. We're first responders. We know how to run chainsaws. We have to get shovels sometimes, and we have to do things that firefighters do. Firefighters help us do things that law enforcement officers usually do, and we become first responders together. So we've experienced that, and we've all been through a lot, but we've been able to get through it together.
You know, I hate to say it, because nobody should go through this over and over again, but it's almost like we're getting good at it.
Yes, we are. We're getting very good at it. And these are the little things that we just learn. You make mistakes, you learn from them, and you move on. And the storms that we've been through have been very horrific. And I would have never thought that this hurricane was as bad as it was. I mean, it was amazing to see some of the things that we've seen after that storm passed through here.
What are you seeing now as far as crime? It looks as though, compared to Baton Rouge and New Orleans, a lot of other places we could mention, Livingston's okay. But on the other hand, what is going on here with relative to crime?
Well, we've all been fortunate here in Livingston to keep a lot of the violent crimes away from this parish. We don't have the gang activities going on like they do across in other parishes across the river. And they're fighting that. Look, I pray for them guys a lot, too, just like I pray for my own guys. And we've been able to maintain the safety here in Livingston Parish. A lot of it's to do with our residents here. They join in with us. They give us information we need to make cases. And we do the best we can to put our thumb on top of things. And I've been very fortunate. You mentioned it earlier. I don't have a big shortfall in employees like a lot of other agencies are fighting. And we are growing fast. My agency's growing fast with it. But we just don't deal with a lot of the problems some of them deal with.
Well, no, you want to talk about the crusade, the Christmas crusade the Sheriff's Office does every year, except during COVID it was diminished, not this year.
Yes, no, we've been doing it every year, and we've watched it grow, especially since 2016, the flood. Actually, the numbers went down because a lot of people moved from here, but our numbers are up pretty high now. We're in our 34th year, started in 1987 under Sheriff Odom Graves, carried on by Sheriff Woodard Graves and then myself. And So we just started a couple of days ago taking applications. That's a two-week process. They can go to lpso.org to get all the information about actually trying to qualify to get toys. You have to be from Livingston Parish. Our deputies at all four locations, it's all three Walmart locations. We also at Bass Pro, the deputies out there on the volunteer on their own time. And we're working our way up to be able to deliver these toys on the delivery day, which is going to be the 17th of December. And we look forward to that day.
So do people give toys or money?
They give both monetary donations as well as new toys. And again, you can drop them off at any of the three Walmart locations or at Bass Pro. If you have a company that wants to collect a bunch of it and want us to come out and collect them from your business, just let us know, contact us, and we'll come out.
And the deputies get to play Santa Claus.
They do. I mean, look, the 17th of December, which is a Friday, is the best day of all, because that's when we get delivered the toys. And all these deputies come from all over. They line up for almost a mile. We cause a lot of traffic problems that morning, but we're going to deliver over 600 to 700 locations before noon, and that's a lot. And these deputies, it's because we all pitch in and we all do our part.
People forget we're at the Chamber of Commerce meeting, and look, the economic statistics on the parish are off the charts.
Yes.
But there's still a lot of poverty in this parish, and the impact of both the flood, and it's not over from the 16 flood, and the hurricane.
Yeah, we see a lot of that, unfortunately. And look, one of the big things, in speaking of Crusade and speaking of that, is the deputies, they see this. And the deputies are really instrumental in actually nominating some families that they're there for usually unfortunate reasons. And those deputies will nominate these families to make sure they get toys, to make sure they have a Christmas. And to see those deputies come in the day of delivery, and they want to make sure they're the ones that deliver those toys, is what it's all about. But unfortunately, we have that, we see it, and all we can do is do the best we can to have these type programs and work with other organizations to fix those type issues.
Well, recap, if you will, how people can help.
Go to lpso.org. You can contact us through the website. Our number is 225-686-2241. Ask for anything to do with the Christmas Crusade if you want to reach out and help. And again, you can go to any of the locations the deputies are going to be at. They're there every weekend. They actually start on Thursdays, and they're there all day at those three Walmart locations or Bass Pro. You can drop all the monetary donation, drop off new toys, or just ask us to come out if it's if you got a business that wants to do a Christmas party and collect toys, get them to us. Just remember, we deliver on December the 5th, the 17th, so it's important to get the stuff to us before that day.
People say there's nothing to do in Livingston Parish.
Yeah, but we're here to tell you, you might want to take another look.
There's always fun things to do.
And it's a great place to play a round of golf. Or two.
And there's always somewhere good to eat.
And there's always great things to see.
Plenty of shopping.
Plenty of shopping.
And there's always a great way to end the day.